Wicked toes, you know what I'm saying? Gotta get that stretch. So this is a super slanted leg extension. There's been like, there's obviously different versions. There's the Jim Lecco one there. It's just like this super slanted, like angled upward, feet being pulled under, like really ripping on patella and like ripping on shin to put you in this awkward position where you almost, you'd have to be here to be relaxed. But now I hold tension, so I'm just holding this tension already. So it's good understanding that there's tension on your leg. And we understand this kick out from shin that I preach and this rolling in that I preach, right? But there's nothing wrong with the angle. So I'm not shitting on the angle, but you're not using the angle properly in the sense that like, I don't need to get to max extension, which is like here, to get my leg to fire. So I can't even get up there. Do you know what I mean? Like, even if I'm pushing higher than where I'd be comfortable pushing, which is right about here, quad engagement, it's peaking on too much. And then I'm using that pull under to sweep out, because leg extension, boys and girls, is not how hard I can kick my foot forward. It's not this, kicking my foot forward and hoping that my quad is working. It's pressure down into the seat, so it's pressure down into hamstrings and into hips and sweeping a foot out. And what I preach is rolling knees in, converging legs a bit. So it's a sweeping motion, which is good here. So, but people get on this, that are off with their movement, and they're like, oh, this thing goes so fucking high, like look how much extension I can get. I need to get it up there because that's where the maximum contraction is. So it's this, you see them, there's no time spent through here, understanding that as this gets heavier, my rep height might only be there. In the sense that I'm only able to squeeze to here, which is like, I'm not even close to locked out. It's just engagement of quad, right? So it's not my goal to go here and go, and then I'm like, and I'm trying to over squeeze this area where it's like I'm fucking rocking on this like tense knee, tense shin, right? So don't think that the height of something and like the contraction horror thing we talk about, it's not about how hard you can squeeze the top. It's the motion throughout the movement, which is more evident on this machine than any machine, because it's already starting with tension, because I'd have to be here to have no tension, like I said. I have tension, so now all I have to do is find that tension and move on it and roll through. Wherever that ends up being that I maximally contract quad, I fall back down. It's not, like you see these people fucking, like trying to kick it behind their head, right? So don't make these mistakes. Like these machines are allowing you to find tension properly and like effectively, and they put you in a range that's safe for you. Stop trying to get past the range. Stop trying to like overemphasize the fucking squeeze. It'd be the same idea as like doing a fucking leg press. And every time we lock on, every time we get to the top of leg press, instead of keeping tension when I'm pressing out, I go and I just slam my knees back and I flex my quads and then I go down again. You wouldn't do it on that. You wouldn't do that on a hack squat or a fucking barbell squat. Why the fuck are you doing it here? And as for you fucking other people, you'll know who you are when you watch this fucking video. We'll show it on this because it's a lot more evident on this. So this idea of, once we understand obviously ranges, which is like the goal of everything, I want to understand like full depth, maximum extension. I understand this pathway. I can control it. That's fine. But then you see these people now, they're like, they get to the top here and then they do this. Yeah, like flexing out, which is okay. You can do it, but don't understand that that's not going to make the difference of your leg development. And you have to have a lot of control and a lot of understanding of where pressure and tension is to be able to understand the whole disposition and then rock here without causing a lot of shearing effect on your knee and a lot of undue stress on like the ligaments in your knee and behind your knee, like your hamstring attachments and everything. Because I'm extended here so hard, there's so much tension here and out here. I'm lucky there's only 30 pounds here. If I had this with 80, which some people do this shit, and I was just rocking here going like this, I already feel my ACL screaming at me and my MCL being like, what the fuck are you doing, man?
If people wanted to do the half reps, would it be better to start at the bottom?
Yeah, that's why the better option is like, if you have if you've mastered control and you can understand this little rock here, I would understand the rock would be a little longer. But I wouldn't, all these people are over-emphasizing this top range going here. I see them. Like, just find a range that allows your knee to relax a bit and then for you to extend quad a bit. But the better option, like you're saying, would be to maybe do a hold to start, which I do with a lot of people, get them to engage iso hold, and then full back to relax, and then rock off bottom. So I'm just getting this quad to fire, I'm not straining knee, and I'm getting just as much out of it because I'm getting more pull on the quad out of the bottom coming halfway up than I ever could here, which is just hip flexor and flipping my foot, right? So you can be all cute with these little gimmicks and shit like that, but you guys have to think about tension, have to think about like tempo and how you would actually, what kind of stress you're putting on your body to do these little gimmicky things, right? So, and understand like moving from the bottom range and kicking out here would be far more effective of half reps than ever out here, which is like, I'm holding, there's so much fucking tension there. That is the maximum point of tension on this machine, right there. Because this thing just wants to fall. If I let go of this, it's gonna fucking bang down. It wants to fucking drop like a stone. So if I'm holding that maximum tension and then I'm rocking off of it with a fucking compromised joint, which is my knee, which is fucking unstable as shit, and I'm rocking here, it's like, yeah, you're getting this contraction thing again, guys, but we don't care about that. We want the stretch. I want to almost feel like when my foot goes down, so if I'm following the path of this, this isn't what's happening, anatomical guys. I'm aware, but this is what it feels like. If my foot's being pulled under, my quad is being pulled down over my knee, it feels like. That's the pressure feeling. When I go to kick out, it's almost like I'm rolling this back up here. And that's how it should feel. It shouldn't feel like individual muscles going boom, 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 fire. It's this pulling and this sliding. My foot's being ripped, my foot's driving out. So I'm driving hip down, and I'm sweeping foot out and flexing quad as hard as I can. My foot gets pulled, there's stretch here, I'm rocking back up through, right? These are the types of like cues and ideologies you can put in people's minds when they do stuff because they understand that. And you can literally like show them visually, like imagine your leg. Now it's all the stress here, we're gonna send it back up, right? Which brings me to another point, which is completely off topic, but trainers, and you know who you are because you're fucking scumbags, stop grabbing your female clients by their fucking inner thighs and touching their ass when you train them, all this nonsense. Like, you're doing it on video. You're doing it on video. So you're literally dry snitching yourself. Because if that person ever claimed it's sexual assault, which it is in some cases, they have visual proof of you doing that. Because you're a scumbag. Like, if I'm training my glutes and me and you're training, Alora, I don't have to touch your glute. I'll be like, this area right here on my butt, this is where we're aiming for. You know what I'm talking about? You have that part of your butt too? Okay, that's what we're doing. I don't need to come up and fucking cup you. Rub your butt, grab your inner thigh. Holy fuck, man, like, if I see that again, I'm gonna lose my mind. Like, talk about like people giving trainers a bad name. Like, there's some of us out there that are like, not, that actually take this seriously and like enjoy what we do and take pride in what we do. We're not just here to meet chicks and fucking get a little cop a feel. I mean, like, you guys that are doing that, you can fuck right off. Don't listen to my shit, like, I'm good. There's some of you out there that are doing it that follow me. Stop following me, because I don't fuck with you. You're a fucking loser. There's a fucking way they describe shit, telling girls to fucking imagine squeezing their fucking, squeeze your this when you feel it. What the fuck are you talking about, dude? Squeeze your fucking, you're really saying that to a girl? And what's wrong with you as a girl that that's okay in your mind? That some random dude you don't know is telling you to squeeze your privates when you're doing a hip thrust or whatever the fuck it is, right? It's like, it's not cool, man. And I don't know how it became cool or it became like an accepted thing, but everyone who's experiencing that needs to say something. You won't catch my ass doing that. I don't even fucking get near someone. I can explain to you, like, this is your delt. This is whatever. When we get in this area, I don't need to be touching you. I don't need to be showing you. I don't need to be anything. We all know where our butt is. We're all aware of it, right? I know where my inner thigh is. So do you. We can use our words like intelligent people and elicit the idea or the concept, right? If you can't do that, then you're a shit trainer. Just get the fuck out of here. It's absolutely ridiculous. It's like, fucking, I saw this video of this guy's doing it. Like, I won't even say his name because I don't give a fuck. to give him any promotion, but like, I've seen it happen in front of my own eyes. Not to say it's happening here, but it's happening.